Hey guys, John Grimsmo here. We are moving. Today's Thursday, January 16th, and we're starting to tear down all the machines and dump all the coolant and get stuff out of the way. And things are going pretty well so far. Today's Thursday, riggers are coming on Monday, so we got a lot of work ahead of us in the next few days. But we're already running into problems and things like that, so we'll get into that. So I'm a huge fan of the Oneida Dust Deputy, but it's too small and the ports are too small and they tend to get full of chips. So when to dump all the coolant, I wanted a bigger solution. So I got this from Lee Valley in Canada. It's a Veritas cyclone lid and, you know, a vacuum in here, water, dust, whatever goes around the outside, except it's upside down, it's pancaked. It's supposed to be up like this. And Once the guys applied suction to it with water, like full suction force, the thing just buckled in and wouldn't seal anymore. But once we pushed it down and created a seal, it worked so well. It filled this entire 55 gallons in like 2 or 3 minutes. It went perfectly. And then nothing got into the vacuum until the water was like 2 inches from the top, and then a little bit got in the vacuum. So that's awesome. This is working really, really well, and it's fast. Time has finally come. We have 2 trucks behind me here and a third one on the way. The 2 UMAC machines are in that one. The Kern is in this one in 3 giant wooden crates. And yeah, they're just waiting for the forklifts to come. They're actually concerned about backing the trucks in here from the road and trying to figure that out. So that's where I'm right now. Just kind of waiting, thinking. So the handy thing about this shop is it's right there. The 2 rigging trucks, and we're gonna walk right now to the old shop so that we can talk with the riggers and be like, here's the plan, here's what we're doing, here's what we're moving. And it's right there. So, super close. You know, my buddy in California, Jay Pearson, set up his new shop about a year and a half ago, and he also moved directly across the street to a different industrial plaza. So that was super handy, super easy move for him. And then my other buddy, Kelvin, from Urban Survival Gear, is moving from California to Texas and building a new shop in Texas. That's a bit of a slap. It's so easy for me to just walk back and forth, but yeah, he's gonna have more challenge just with the distance. But I'm not going to miss this driveway, I'll tell you that much. Tight angle park driveway. There's not enough parking spots because we're hiring more people and we got like, 10 vehicles here, like a trailer, and an old car. And yeah. It's good. This truck, we have the 2 UMAC machines, the used mills that I picked up. I'm very excited for those. They're gonna be awesome once we got some broken stuff on them we gotta fix up. But right now, we're just gonna let the drivers do what they do. They're the experts at this. Try not to micromanage, but they know what they're doing. Expensive, but still, it's still nerve-wracking watching it, you know, 5 feet up in the air. The forks are like this far apart, super central. It's weird because it's a big machine, but you gotta think, all of this is just sheet metal, and all this is just sheet metal. And all the weight is actually just right in the center. And sometimes the center of gravity is different. It's not dead center. So these guys are really good about
tip over, like all the way to right here in the middle. First of all, what do you think of filming in the new shop? This is super exciting. Okay, UMAX are done. Next thing, that truck's gonna go out. The current truck is gonna back in, and they're gonna unload the three current pallets. Now, as long as we have to get in there with the impact gun, they use T20 torques on the entire pallet, so we have to untorque the thing and get it off the pallet. So I've been in contact with Current USA, with Tony down there, and he said, okay, this is what you do, here's what you're allowed to do, you're not allowed to do, things like that. So I know exactly what to do, and the truck's in here. Done.
Cue epic B-roll sequence. Oh, it smells like Germany. Oh, that is some Kern Red. Yes. Get some. Not funny. So if I'm right, Steven, crazy, you gotta see this.
This right says Kern.
Even better, this is stickers.
Let's go, dude.
Okay, I'm gonna explain. Okay, so this is the Aroa pallet changer. Now this exact unit went to the Emo trade show in Germany back in September, I think. And on our podcast, The Business of Machining, John Saunders made a joke, like just a 4-second joke of like, everybody going to Emo, you need to sticker bomb Grimsmo's Aroa. And they did. And it's epic. Okay, check this out. I caught a glimpse of it. Ready? Ah. That is so cool. That's so cool, right? It like warms my heart. That's really nice. The funny thing is, at the trade show, guys were going up putting their stickers on, and whoever was running the booth was like, oh, you can't do that. That's not, you're defacing the property. And they're like, no, it's cool. So there's a day or two of that, and then eventually everybody at Kern got on board. It was hilarious. So the guy was peeling the stickers off, but then everybody came back, slapped more stickers on, and I was like, guys, it's cool. Keep the stickers on. This is the greatest thing ever. And in German, it says, you know, caution, don't remove the stickers or whatever that says.
Literally jumping for joy, John.
This is crazy.
You can fit this in.
Guys, it has been 3 weeks since that moving day that you just saw. We are fully moved in, still getting our bearings going, still getting everything back hooked up in production. The Kern is here. I've done my training. I've had guys in from Germany. Like, so much has happened. We've taken quite a bit of footage over that time, but I want to show you guys how we laid everything out and quick little sneak peeks of videos to come. Everything's going to be a video to come, but let's check this place out. So we decided to put the Kern at this weird, like, I think it was a 30 degree angle. It happens to be exact right angle from the Mori, I think. Anyway, I had to choose where to put the machines based on the where the pads are and how the weight's going to go and where all the feet can sit. But I also wanted a working cell here in the middle. So it's starting to work out, because the Kern can only fit in so many places without encroaching on this aisle that we have down the middle. So basically all here, like, it's full of stuff now, but it's a relatively open area. And then over here we got the Mori. Angelo's making Norseman parts right now. We've reset up the same cell that we had before, the same table, Kennedy, my old toolbox, and it kind of gets us right back into normal production, which is the goal. Found a killer deal on a bunch of shelving and tons of office furniture. Maybe we'll take a quick buzz through there. And yeah, just locally. So we walked it across the street along with the rest of our stuff. So we got the Tornos also at an angle. I tried every layout imaginable. If I put sideways or long ways or angled or angled this way, and I kept going back and forth and back and forth. But in the end, I'm really, really happy with this setup. If we set up our desks and, like, working areas here in the middle, you can see every machine. And I don't think I've actually stepped back and done that 360. That's really cool. I knew it. I knew the theory was there. But I can see every machine from right here. That's really cool. Yeah, so there's so many kind of surreal moments of, it's like, whoa, it is, it did work out. So Sky's putting together the weigh covers of the Tornos. Angelo's leveling the bar feeder, which ends up being a very big job. Everything's got to be just lined up perfect. And then we got the coolant tanks here. They're going back together. We had a stainless steel drip tray made up, because this thing drips, like, so annoyingly. So Buddy Bar's Combat Beads on Instagram welded that out of stainless steel for us, and it's epic. And then we got the Nakamura over here, also at the exact same angle as the Tornos and offset. There's plenty of room between machines. Like, at the old shop, we were just tripping over each other. Everything was so tight, and now there's room to breathe, like, so much room. We put a bunch of room behind the Nakamura for an eventual bar feeder, just in case. It would go right here to about here. And I really wanted to have a clear walking path behind all the machines. So whether you're walking or you're pushing a cart or everything, it's starting to get encroached a little bit with the shelves and the toolboxes and the sinks, but even still, like, you can get all the way around every machine, and that's a key point. We're gonna do another video talking about power, lighting, and plumbing. But I mean, you can start to see what we've done. I guess I'll save that for the next video. Still got a ton of room here in the corner. Plenty of room for another machine if we really needed to, which of course we will eventually. But, and then we got the two used UMAC machines over here. I'm super excited about these. I got them for a killer deal. They're from 2002. They're Taiwanese machines, but they use like really epic Siemens components and Heidenheim control. And it's like almost the exact same control as my brand new Kern has on it, which is really cool. So they'll be the beater machines. They'll be, they'll just get stuff done. They'll cut foam, they'll cut rough operations, dovetail clamps, all kinds of stuff. It'll be really nice to have. And then we also picked up, kind of last minute, we picked up a new air compressor. Got a Kaiser SM10 because we now have two buildings. Our old air compressor went in the front building and we needed a new compressor for this building. So yeah, bought that. It's epic, it's loud, it idles. You can hear it idling now, it's not doing anything. It just sits there and it idles and it makes that loud noise. So kind of annoying, kind of drowns the shop and just white noise. But I mean, look at this place. Look at this place, it's sick. Yeah, so it's been a really, really busy 6 weeks, first 6 weeks of the year. But these Uline carts are gold. Love these things. We've been using them a lot. I want to buy a lot more now that we actually have room to drive them. The windows are amazing. They're actually kind of annoying because if you're working here and like when the sun comes down and blasts that table, you're getting like a sunburn on your neck. And your tools heat up from the sunlight, and you know there's some downsides. We might put a blind on this window, but to have daylight coming through the other windows and just, it's amazing. It's so nice in here. I've completely forgotten about the old shop. It doesn't exist to me anymore. So we got Steven over here working on the lapping machine, bending blades with the arbor press. He's got a really nice cell set up here. This table, I don't think I've ever said it, but this table has been a staple of Grimsmo Knives. I built this thing from a door that I found in a barn in 2008. My first lathe went on there, and it just kept getting added to and added to, and it's cool to be able to still use it. So this is, I don't even know exactly, it's about 4,000 square feet, maybe 3,500 or so of actual shop space. The floors turned out nuts. Like, get a shot that way and just pay attention to the floors. Like, it makes the whole place just bright and airy and epic. Moving the machines in didn't do too much to the floors. We only had a few scuffs where the forklifts like went that way. We put cardboard by the door so that it was really snowy and like salty outside. So the cardboard soaked up some of the snow and kind of got the salt off the wheels. That worked out really well. And now we just got to maintain. We got to sweep and mop kind of often. And it is quite slippery when it's wet. So just little things we got to keep in mind. So then in here we got shipping desk. So we got the shipping computer, pen storage. Knives get, like boxes get assembled here, label printer. We're using a Rollo printer, very happy with that. Very happy with the Rollo. The Dymo printer like needs an office space type def. And here we got a storage room. Put two more shelves in here. We've got storage, all our knife cases, padding. I'm using this area to check every knife as we finish it. Shipping table, all the boxes get assembled and like tape and things like that, and then having a storage rack of stuff is excellent. Got our Saga pen cases. Ooh. Yeah, it's like everything we've wanted to do in a business, we actually get to do and have the space to do it right now. And just to have areas for stuff is so amazing. There's a bathroom right there, which is super handy. Epic checkerboard floors. We've turned this was an office from the old people. We turned it into our kitchen slash break room. Found this epic table with chairs for super cheap. Got a fridge in. There's another bathroom right over here. You don't need to see it, but it's, you know, a bathroom. Kind of weird to have a bathroom in a kitchen, but we'll balance that as necessary. But yeah, it's nice because it's, you know, that shop is loud. It's nice to just go, okay, let's take a breath. Let's chill, you know, have a conversation, whatever. It's awesome. Take you quick upstairs. Now, I've had almost nothing to do with the upstairs because I'm so focused on that. I'm like, you guys handle it. So Fraser and Barry and the other guys just took care of it. They found all the office furniture. Barry's on the phone, so we got to whisper.
Can I have the difference in cash, Grandpa?
I'm just filming a video. So Barry's in there on the phone. And Fraser's office, I don't know if you want to show it off or not, but double monitor set up. So
this is literally the video that we're editing right now.
We're editing this video.
Yeah.
Inception. So you got your photo booth here, which he's going to revamp. We've had this for years.
It's very temporary.
Yeah, we'll do better. But yeah, you got space to work. You got space for your stuff. It's really cool, eh? It's really cool. There's another bathroom right here.
More epic tile floor.
So Barry's office, little sink room. I don't even know. Sweet, and then my office in here. As you can see, I've fully moved in with just my Rode mic, and that's about it. But that's epic. I mean, you guys killed it with this office furniture. One day, I've been using my computer downstairs. I just want to bring it up here and close the door and like actually get some work done sometimes. But it's sick. There's a window. I can see the whole shop. Yeah, this is sweet. I mean, it doesn't even open more than that. So what do you guys think? I mean, this place is incredible. It's like a dream come true. I'm like a kid working here now. Eventually I got to replace this plexiglass with an actual like double or triple pane window, but I mean, we started in our garage 10 years ago with nothing, absolutely nothing. We've slowly built it up through time and effort and planning and execution and hiring excellent talent, and just, we struggle like everybody else does, but the better we get. And it's been a fun journey, and guys, we're just getting started. We're gonna be happy here for quite a while, and there's a lot of amazing things to come. So thank you guys all for supporting us and for following us and watching all the videos and validating everything we're doing. Like, it lets us know we're on the right track because you guys are buying and you're happy, and you know, because we're doing this for you. I don't film videos for my benefit, for my watching, it's my benefit, but no, we do it all for you guys, and we appreciate you guys following along. So there's lots coming. We got so many ideas, we got so many plans. Anyway, I think that solidly wraps up this video.